Is it finally the end of the road for my caddy? Well, sadly, yes it is.
Well, that's the problem there. That is why she's run like a bag of sh**.
This time we head to Cremin for the end of season destruction derby. And I finally get to find out why the van ran so badly. For the last few weeks it's been running that badly, it even gives Uncle Buck's old battered up Mercury a run for its money. So sit back and enjoy, and oh yeah, wait till the end, I'm going to show you the new van as well.
Come on!
I think the caddy might make this. I only have to get round this corner, down the hill a wee bit, and then that's me.
For the past couple of weeks, this really has been my daily reality. That's the rattling noise that's been taking the caddy to the side of the road, and it's the straw that finally broke the camel's back. So on the way to Cremin, I had to play passenger. There was absolutely no way the caddy was going to make the journey. It barely made it to my friend's house.
He's a good boy, Harry.
It's our second trip there this year. Usually, there's something for sale in the car park. Maybe something nice like this Renault Master, that kind of looks promising. After the mini stocks and the passenger runs, well, the destruction derby, if I'm brutally honest, it was a little bit of a disappointment. There weren't that many cars out on the track. We did actually joke at one point about bumping up the numbers by chucking the caddy in and entering that. In points recently, it has been quite tempting. Here's another potential. This lovely old 1970s Morris Maxi. There's no MOT. A little bit of work will get it done.
Harry! What's this? Good boy.
Now, the issue I've discovered recently is that places like Facebook Marketplace, they're just swamped with fake adverts. You know the type, 19 plate van, give me 500 quid for it. The ones that are quite clearly too good to be true. And they're an absolute waste of time. The genuine adverts, they're for battered up old ropey cars. There are a couple of traders near to me who seem to be doing all right off this though. They're selling cars out of health centre car parks and the local Tesco's. One of my friends got bitten quite recently. We didn't know this guy existed. she pulled up and bought a car, and it was an absolute ringer. Now, because she doesn't know where the guy stays, trying to deal with him through any means is just pointless. He doesn't trade from his home address. It's always, oh, I'll meet you at a shopping centre. As you can imagine, I was starting to get quite frustrated with the whole situation. One of the guys at work suggested I limp the caddy up to his so we could look at the engine and try and get to the bottom of why it was smoking and running so badly. His son Ali's a mechanic, and he was 99% sure that the injector seals had failed. Which is kind of weird because I've got a pile of receipts from the previous owners, and they've definitely been done before. The problem is, because the engine's been swapped, I don't know which engine got the replacement seals done. I really had no way of knowing, so for the sake of 15 quid and an hour of the guy's labour, it was worth the punt. It did, however, mean trying to get the caddy to Turriff, which is about half an hour north of Aberdeen, or about an hour and a half when your car resembles Uncle Buck's. Give him his dues, Ali was absolutely spot on. Turns out, injector 3 had failed quite badly. You can see a bit of wear in the seal there. This is why the engine oil was so watery. It's why everything was going wrong. So we used the replacement kit, swapped out all the injector seals. It turned out the EGR actually came out of this okay, but we're in about anyway, might as well chuck on a new one. And after that, ever since, she's been starting first turn of the key. And on the drive to Cruden Bay, she ran brilliantly. Well, as brilliantly as an old SDI caddy can run. I mean, this thing's gutless when it left the factory. But on the way to my friend's house, it's the best that's ever ran in my entire ownership. But honestly, there comes a point when you've just got to say enough's enough. I don't regret buying the caddy. What I do regret is paying what I did for it. I was absolutely fleeced. You got to understand, I bought the van at a point when I was at my absolute lowest. My mental health was tanking. I'd just been made redundant and was going through the beginning of a divorce. I got this thing when, quite honestly, there were days I just didn't want to get out of my bed. But this thing got me out of the house. Even if I did have to phone the AA a couple of times to get me back home again. So yeah, thank you, caddy. I mean it. Hopefully you're a little bit luckier for your next owner. So like I mentioned, I went to my pal's house. This was to look at a van, and if I'm honest, this kind of came out of the blue. Like I said before, I'd been looking for a while without any joy. All the leads I had for decent vans were coming up dead ends. I was struggling to even get as far as viewing, partly because I didn't think the van would make it, and partly because people don't actually want to sell their vans, it turns out. Then I got a phone call from Gina out of the blue, saying that her hubby's van was up for sale. Now, he's only the third owner of it. I believe it started off life as an enterprise hire van. Going by the sticker residue that's left on the sliding door anyway. And for its age, it's in really good shape. It's only done about 103,000 miles, it's MOT'd for the best part of a year, and before you say it...
Yes, it's dirty, I'll get it fixed. Let's do a quick van tour. So at the moment, unlike the caddy, there's absolutely nothing in there. Although Magic has very kindly left me a power inverter. But his exact words to me were, don't think about plugging in anything big like a telly, so yeah, that won't be happening.
She's got a couple of whirlwinds. There's that. Doesn't seem to shut.
Now, taking the plate off the caddy strangely makes it feel quite final. But yeah, I've got a van.
to be fair. I honestly didn't think I'd end up with one. Any van in Aberdeen at the moment that isn't an absolute ringer has been a complete and utter mare because of the issues of the caddy. This time round, I've been really careful that I'm getting a van that I want to buy and one that's going to do me well. And this is one of these few times in my life when my patience has paid off. Magic had always sort of said, openly and honestly, I wouldn't want to sell you a van in case something happens and, you know, you fall out with this over it. And not that I ever would, but I kind of understand his logic. I know how well the van's been looked after. It's not immaculate, it's a 12-year-old Transit. But because this has been his works vehicle, it's had to be maintained. He had a garage full of spare parts. So he's got his new van, I've got my new van, and it's kind of fitting because growing up, my dad drove the milk vans for Wiseman's and got the vans home. And I'll tell you what, his old smiley Transits, the old Mark 5s, they weren't nearly as luxurious as this. I mean, this has got power steering, I've got a 6-speed box. The only disappointing thing is, the day that I came to view this was the day, and I'm not making this up by the way, was the day that we finally got to the bottom of the caddy's starting issues. I don't know how many mechanics between my ownership and previous owners. I don't know how much time and money has been spent trying to get to the bottom of the issues. It's had a new engine somewhere down the line. I can tell you now, and this is the actual cause of it running like a sack of tatties for the last few years, injector seal number 3. Looks like someone had either nicked it with a knife or slackened it off with a screwdriver when they were trying to fit it onto the injector. So because there was a little bit of play, diesel was getting directly into the oil in the engine, and by the time this happened with me, honestly, the oil was like water. I must have put in about 4.5 litres or whatever you're meant to put in when I serviced it. I slightly overfilled it, but not to the degree that it was literally just gushing out of anywhere in the engine it could do. Now with the injector seal on, they've all been replaced. The engine's been emptied of the diesel-y oily mix. There's a new EGR valve on it. Genuinely, timing belt and a camshaft position sensor. This engine is going to be good for another, I would guess, at least 50,000 miles, maybe more. But, you know, that's going to be somebody else's pride and joy now with any luck. I'm going to get it listed and hopefully sold on so I can get the parts. As I say, I can get the parts I need for this van. It doesn't really need anything. But Maciek's pile of spares could come in handy. He's got drive shafts, front wheel bearings, brake discs and pads. You know, if I can get them on a deal, which Maciek's already offered, makes sense. I can have them sat in the loft, good to go whenever they're needed. I'm not in any particular rush. It'd just be nice to have a bit of peace of mind. So yeah, there we go. New van is here. Downside being, of course, now I've got all that work to do. However, because the caddy had the Terrain conversion, it was an absolute pig to build the bed and do anything where you wanted straight lines and straight edges. This is a panel van. Touch wood. It's going to be a lot easier to kit out. So next time out, I've got a couple of small repairs to do. The wing mirror casings, as you saw, were not the best. I've managed to get one wing mirror from work, so I'm going to get that fitted. Although I was sitting thinking, great, 3 bolts. How hard can that be? Speaking to the fitters at work, it turns out it's actually a bit of a pig of a job. Hopefully it won't be too bad, but I'm going to get the mirror changed and I think I'll sit down as well and try and work out what I'm going to do. I've got a reasonably good idea in my head of how I want the van to be, but it still has to be practical. At the end of the day, this is my daily driver. It's not low emission zone compliant, so when I go and do my radio stuff at the weekend, I can't take it to the works car park. I'm still going to have to park nearby, but this time it's a fully conscious decision. With the caddy, I was kind of conned. It came up as LEZ compliant, like I said before, because the woman who owned it, or whose name was on the V5, she was registered disabled. I'm guessing she had an exemption. I had no way of kind of knowing that, but with the Transit, I know I can't get into the city centre. That's part of the reason Maciek wanted rid of it. Yeah, a lot to do. Next time out, I've got a wing mirror to change. We'll try, and let's see if we can't get a plan in place for the rest of the van. I'm not going to go nuts, but it'll be good. As always, thanks very much for watching. If you haven't done, if you want to keep up to date with what I'm going to be doing ahead, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification button, and yeah, if you've got any Transit parts for sale, might need them. Starts on the button, which is good.